Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm talking about the MidFace and three tips to help particularly with microcannula injections of the MidFace. And Restylane Lift was recently approved just for this use. Now, it's a hyaluronic acid filler. It's been around for a long time, but it's very big because the microcannula is the best way to fill the MidFace. So it's going to revolutionize how the majority of the country fills, because they're using needles now, probably about 80%. And the MidFace has a lot of structures we want to avoid. The microcannula is blunt. There's many videos we've done on the microcannula, and we're going to do some more to come, particularly outlining how to get the injection points. Restylane Lift is approved for the hands, the nasal folds, and the MidFace, and in the MidFace particularly, up to 6 mLs per treatment session. So tip number one for the MidFace is go deeper. The microcannula is blunt, and I prefer 25 gauge, but you can get to those deeper layers, particularly laterally along the zygoma. Anteriorly, you have to be careful lower so that you're not intraorally, but as you move up towards the maxilla, we can be deeper. A lot of people are going to say, well, the infraorbital nerve is there, and the patient will tell you when you're deep along the infraorbital nerve, but in general, we want to go deeper. It avoids a lot of the structures. The cannula does get to the deeper layers in the MidFace, unlike the temple where you can't get there because it's blunt. You can in the MidFace because of the nature of the tissues, and you see the product less. It gives a better result. And mentally, think about putting a facial implant in. Really, that's what we're doing with fillers. An implant that can be adjusted over time and looks natural and can be added and subtracted as the patient desires with hyaluronic acid filler. Number two, avoid the middle temporal vein. I see this a lot, particularly with the needle technique. People put their finger on the zygoma. However, they inject a little bit above it, and right there is where an important vein and artery structure exists and have been implicated in ocular side effects. So know if you're using a needle that you're on bone, and I submit also with a cannula. Sometimes to create beauty with a cannula, you're going to be at an angle that's above the zygoma superiorly to create that beautiful angle, particularly for a model-like look. However, with the cannula, I'm more comfortable because I can be in the subcutaneous tissue until I hit the bone, and then I can slide down. If using a needle particularly, that middle vessel is one to avoid. Number three is cleanliness. The cannula I use is typically 2 inches. A lot of times in training, it'll be a 1.5 inch, but with a full syringe, that's a long device, and the hair is right there. And as much as we think our hair is clean, we're only supposed to wash it a couple times a week. So that's what they tell me. The hair is not clean, and the cannula often touches the hair. And particularly if you're using products that lend themselves to delayed nodules or are long-term products that might form nodules, biofilm, or other issues, keep the cannula clean. And I show in my videos, you can put a 4x4, a sterile 4x4, or you can put hypochlorous or maybe even alcohol, something to make sure you have a clean gauze to cover the hair, give yourself a clean zone to work with, because it is a long instrument and you are going deep. And these problems can come up months and even years down the road. So the cannula, if it gets dirty, discard it. They're $5 or $10, it's well worth it, but keep the zone clean. So there's three tips, something I've learned recently on the MidFace injection technique through the cadaver dissection at University of Southern California just last week. And join us on Instagram for further tips. Subscribe to this channel to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.